Alright, hello everyone. We're back with more Digimon. We're gonna rework our strategy. Alright, let's see what we... Let's see, where's my... Looks like I'll just have to raise another one. Okay, so... I wanna get a fighter personality for this one. Reason we want to do that is because we want. I'm gonna raise another physical attacker that'll help us with the first boss in this. Oh shoot, no. I don't wanna. Probably gonna take a bit, but it'll be worth it. Yep, we're going to be doing some on-screen grinding. Ah, there we go. Now we want two fighters, because... Because both the Digimon I'm going to try to raise to help with this boss are going to be physical attackers. And I want them to hit as hard as possible. It's easier to start. Ah, there we go, fighter. Now we grind. Time to rise and grind, gamers. Let's see. I am gonna need him just for a bit anyway. actually, there's some other Digimon I'm kind of gonna need to try to raise. Cause the whole goal of this is to raise Digimon I haven't used before, and this is gonna be another one of them. Actually, let me see something real quick. Goblimon. Nope. Don't need a searcher. No, don't need Nimble. It's kind of convenient that you can pretty much raise the perfect Digimon for yourself as early as you want. I like that about this game. I guess this is sort of a grind and chill stream. Ah, there we go, fighter. I'm pretty sure that's the personality I wanted. I'm just making sure. Let's see. Yes, it is. It should be easy to get the I'm gonna be raising another Platinum Numamon too while I'm at it, so it'll be easier to get the XP I need for this. And I needed Omni Shentmon with me too, because oh, I do have him with me. Okay, just had to make sure, because then I can force encounters without having to move. Now basically what I'm trying to do is raise some vaccine Digimon to deal with the virus boss. I'm probably gonna turn the animations off so it'll go by much quicker. See that? That's a lot of EXP, and I'll get even more if I get another Platinum Numamon. Let's see. Battle cutscenes. Short. Is it on short? No, I gotta... There we go. Settings. There we go. Alright. Yep. Just making sure I've got the right one and I'm going down the right path. That should be pretty easy to, let's see, 55? 21. Okay, that should be pretty easy to get to. Because I'm gonna go up to Leomon, and I'm also gonna go down to, Arcadiamon Rookie so I can get acceleration boost. Let's see. What was I gonna do with this one? Oh yeah, I need to keep getting its camp. This one, let's see. Let me take a look at the Digimon Pathfinder. There's basically a site for Digimon Digivolution paths, so it's easier to find the paths for evolution I'm trying to get. Goblimon to Platinum Numamon, Animon, Superstarmon. Okay. Attack 70, defense 80. Okay, that should be easy enough to do. SP 70. Alright, this should be reasonable enough to do. What was I doing with this guy again? I feel like there's another Digimon in my party I was gonna use him for, but I forgot. Dagnabbit. Oh, that's what I was gonna use the Otomomon for. I forgot. I gotta return him to Data then, so I can, Oh, no, wait. I was gonna get... Oh, right. I was gonna get this guy to Platinum Numamon, and then to... Okay, I remember now. Sorry about that. Let's see. Where's my that Nanamon again? Okay, so my mistake. Let's see again. Okay. Otomomon to Platinum Numamon, that's what I was trying to do. Okay. Now I see what I'm doing wrong. Otomomon to Rarimon. Then I can just Digivolve him to Black King Numamon. Then from there I can go up to Platinum Numamon. That'll be much easier to do. And I was gonna do this guy. Nanimon to... Okay. This looks easier to do. All right, now I have a good idea of what I'm doing. Now let's get back out there, and also let's change our party Digimon. Get her to get some camaraderie. Going her out front to get all the cam boosts. I like to save between a lot of things because, like, I don't want to have to do all this stuff over, you know? See, having the animations off and forcing encounters makes this whole process go by a lot faster. So glad I can do this much faster thanks to these Platinum Numamon and New Game Plus. 32. Okay, that's gonna be a while. Right, so it's at 55. Just a few more levels then. Down to Arcadiamon Rookie so we can get acceleration boost. Alright, let's see. And then from. And for Lalamon. Go up to Vegemon. Down to Gabumon Black. And we're gonna go up. Can't digivolve him yet. Can't digivolve that yet. Keeping that, and... Well, back to battling. Minna, are so beautiful, aren't they? Kidimon rookie get acceleration boost again. Oh, level 6. I should have already gotten it by now then. So we're getting this guy. What were we doing? Right, we were getting this guy to Garurumon Black. And then back, and then down to Gazimon. Yet, let's see. That. I think this is the one we were planning to keep as Leomon. Yeah, we'll keep him like that just for now. Sure, I got everything in order. Let's see what I got for skills on this thing. All right. Now we got another one of our permanent team members, I think. Let's see. Da-da-da. Maybe I should probably nickname these things so it's easier to keep track of them. Oh well. Okay, yeah, I remember now what we're doing. Okay. Now let's get back out there. I like going for acceleration boost as early as possible because, like, it's just a really good skill, and it's pretty easy to get it early. early on from things like Tyrannomon or Arcadiamon Rookie, Monochromon if you know which lines to go down. So for the Gazimon. Kurisarimon. Down to Arcadiamon Rookie. Oh no, yeah. I'm gonna keep digivolving this guy down this particular line so he keeps getting ABI. Making sure I don't max out as level 1, but I don't mean to or something. Yeah, still not the level for Black King Numlon here. So that's gonna be a while. Let's see how this guy's going. 8% cam, so we're getting there on that. Actually, we can digi-convert a few things, and then just... A great thing about digi-convert is that the Digimon you get out of it, you can just use as level fodder. I'm gonna do that real quick. I don't really need... All these guys have fighters. Okay, let's see. Hello, Digimon. Arcadiamon Rookie. Got acceleration boost out of that too. Here we go. Needs to be level 16. Looks like I need to go out and get another battle. Monodramon. Then down to Sunomon. They're easier for me to tell apart which one I'm digivolving to which, I can much more easily go down certain lines. Right, I can digivolve this guy down to Arcadiamon Rookie now for acceleration boost. And then I'll digivolve him right back up. Digivolve the main team I wanted to raise to ultimates. Oh hey, I can for Tyrannomon at least. Gonna do that real quick just for the ABI. Not really gonna use this yet. For now I'm gonna focus on Tyrannomon. Like, this is the very first chapter of the game. We don't need that kind of power just yet. Oh hey, Darklaw Delta is here. Hello, Darklaw Delta. I'm just here grinding away, trying to get some vaccine Digimon I haven't used yet, so it'll be easier to deal with this first boss. You'll see which teammates I'm gonna be. I was planning on investing in just a moment. This Arcadiamon Rookie has acceleration boost. We can go ahead and digivolve him back up to Leomon. There we go. I'm basically gonna get, what's that? Panjamon. Yeah, that's what it is. That's gonna be perfect for, and Frigimon for, dealing with that Growlmon boss. The water vaccine should help a ton. Oh, I forgot to Digivolve the Yokomon I had. I'll get right to that in just a moment. Oh, I should finally be able to Digivolve my Rarimon now, too. Alright, Rarimon. Wakinumon time. Now we just need to get this guy to level 65, and then we're in the gold. And then we're in the platinum. The cam 100% for Wormmon is going to be the hard part, but once I get that, I'll be able to use Hudiemon, and in a play in a casual playthrough, that'll be fun. And now we can Digivolve Kuwagamon into Akuamon. But we're still not, but we're not gonna do that for now. We're just gonna, well, except for the ABI, of course. I wanna stick to the champion and rookie levels, because I like those guys. At least for the moment, because we're still in the early game. Let's see, got him on black. Ah, there we go, Frigimon now. Perfect. Now I have all these Digimon I haven't used before, and I'm gonna be able to use them against the boss after I get a few. I'm gonna get him up to like level 30. That should be a good enough level to keep them to be strong enough to be able to beat this boss reasonably. Hold on. Isn't there a whole item that increases cam? I think there is. Let's see. There's a whole item for that. Oh well. How much can I add anyway? Oh man, I'm getting a cam at 100%, that's gonna be hard. Actually, no, I could just use the best. I could just soft reset cheese the best meat. That's probably the way to go. I'll probably do that off stream sometime. Now let's go ahead and get all these guys up to level 30. Then I'll turn the animations back on and go ham on that boss. Digimon has such a cute design. I don't know why I never used it sooner, but pretty soon I'll be able to. Ah, whoop. Didn't mean to do that. I can't. Let me see if I can digivolve any of my guys up just for a second. Yeah, as I expected, well, 100% cam is the only thing that I can't really do right now. Oh yeah, and I forgot I planned to get him to Panjimon, so I gotta get him up 8 more levels, seems, for the speed. That shouldn't take long. With the levels up I'm getting. Let me know if there's anything wrong with the audio, if it needs to turn anything up or anything. Speed at what, 75? See that level growth starting to slow down a little. Oh, it looks like I only need to get up one more level. This would be perfect for taking out that boss. Let me see something real quick. Pre-type Digimon, which is Rookie or better. Oh, then I can just put Omnishotmon back and carry my Kurisarimon. That looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and digivolve my Kurisari to Infermon because just so I always have that free type. I'm gonna use Diaboromon down the line. Cause I'm using Digimon I never used before, so it'll be fun. Alright. This looks good. Now I can reorganize my team so I can. I should be plenty equipped to take out that boss. And with Digimon I never used before. skills are in order. Playing coverage on that. I forgot Frigimon also learns how to heal. Work with on Gekkomon, didn't go up a lot of other paths for it, but this should be good for now. Frigimon's walk's so cute. Alright, here we go. This should be much better, easier now. Oh wait, I forgot to turn the animations back on. I want to see those animations. Good thing I saved beforehand. Because, like, since I haven't used these Digimon as much as others, I haven't gotten to get a good look at their animations, and this game has good animations, so I want to be able to see it, you know? Alright, let's fix that. There we go, normal. Alright, back to business. Now, here we go. Now we can see all those great animations. We're mostly water, and we have vaccine waters, so he can't really do anything to hurt us now. It's device! Oh, juice. Sub-Zero Ice Punch. There we go. And now you got to see me dominate that boss in two attacks made me cut my stream short last time.
Naruhodo. Buji de nani yori da yo. Dejimon wo collection suru ningen ga iru. Ningen no aku. Shikashi, shieki shite ita hazu. Genjitsu sekai ni okeru Dejimon ga gokurou datta. Shujuu no ka. Sou omowanai.
Here we go.
Yamashina Makoto, genjusho mo sude ni sono katei de ni.
I guess that boss fight is a good example of how much this game rewards smart team building. That's what I like. That's what I love from Monster Collector.
Thank you.
Now we do cases. And now that we got that out of the way, we can just go back to our main team that we were planning on using. Off to see Mirei. I'm gonna do something real quick. I'm gonna exploit the exciting meat. Gonna get my Wormmon's cam up so I can just go ahead and get that Houdiemon already. Also need to get my use my memory up. Now I can start try to abuse the exciting meat. This little caterpillar, be my friend. Okay, that's perfect. And now that she's our friend, we can go ahead and make her blossom. Isn't she beautiful? This was the Digimon I saved for last for my field guide when I complete the field guide in Hacker's Memory. Probably have to go de-digivolver and stuff to get acceleration boost. You know how it is. At least now I can get. At least now you can rest assured she's gonna be a permanent teammate. I'll go ahead and do that off stream. I'm gonna go ahead and continue with the. Wait, what was I doing? Alright, let's go talk to her again. Okay, go to Kowloon level 2. There's that NPC we're supposed to be looking for, I guess. I love Tyrannomon. I kind of like Tyrannomon's walk-run animation. Just like a dinosaur or a Yoshi. Pretty cute. Get out of our way. Thank you, Quagamon. I imagine we're gonna have to battle this guy, so I'm saving real quick. That horn attack. That's what I call a horn attack. I'm actually starting to like Quagamon's anime a lot more thanks to this playthrough. Even though he's a generic bad guy Digimon and all that. Thank you. these guys are kind of great in their champion forms. It'll be a shame when I'll have to digivolve them to ultimate. But it'll still be fun, and they'll still be technically there in spirit since I'm using their respective digivolutions of Okuomon, Shogengekkomon, and Metal Tyrannomon. Speaking of which, I kind of like Metal Tyrannomon versus Metal Greymon in the Digimon Adventure 2020 anime. That was a pretty cool fight. Sorry for spoilers if anyone was planning on watching that. So that's one out of 30 hackers taken care of. I'm probably going to stream this for like another 40 minutes or so, just to let anyone know. I should probably heal up my MP. I was checking to make sure that in case. Three crown level one hackers, okay. Yeah, so basically throughout the story you're going to be doing little mini quests, little side quests like this in order to be able to advance the plot. They're kind of mandatory in a sort of way, I guess. I feel like it'd probably be better if the... But they make for some decent little side plots. I think they're pretty good. Plus they open up new grinding areas early in the story. Though I don't really need that since I'm playing New Game Plus. As you can see, I'm pretty strong, all things considered. Like, at this point in the game, if I were playing it on regular story mode, I'd only be able to have one champion on my team. I've got like three champions right now. Get into Renamon. Yeah, I forgot to turn the encounter rates down. It's kind of funny how Gekkomon is one of those champion levels that's really small for a champion, like Gatomon. I always think it's funny. Or Sukumon. That's always funny too. I wouldn't mind if there were other champion level Digimon that are small. That'd be cool. Oh right, I was turning the encounter rates down. I'm just gonna do this to show off their signature move animations for the fun of it. I thought that would take him out. Ah, one of those insta-death skills. Ah, Tyrannomon's so happy. Yay, my frog friend died, but we won. Looks like I'd better heal up my Gekkomon just in case. I got plenty of HP capsules and they basically hand these out in the story. another little side quest done. I think one more and that should be a pretty good stopping place. Right, we're gonna jump into his phone. Yeah, this is what I was kind of talking about. Sometimes quests give you these really good grinding spots, but I don't really need this right now. Like, you can get stronger than usual Digimon than you would be able to, like, in like the early stages of Kowloon. Of course, this isn't one of them, it seems. Answered any of my digital lines, that's not good. I kept forgetting about that. Get these items real quick. Oh yeah, Tokemon has that horrifying mouth full of razor sharp teeth. It's always so funny when you see it animated. Oh god! Oh, that face. Gotta beat up this little jellyfish. Oh, okay, so he's actually stronger than we thought. Gonna have to bring out the acceleration boost. He's a free type, so he doesn't really have any weaknesses I can exploit. That's kind of the cool thing about being a true neutral type in an RPG. Dark Law Delta saying, Tokemon's still cute. Yeah, Tokemon is still pretty cute. This damn jellyfish is so ridiculous. Imagine coming across a jellyfish with actual spine. Thanks for the amazing game. Thank you, Ben, Bandai Namco, for this amazing game. And all the other development companies that gave us this game. Go to the Digilab real quick, get my SP and HP back up. I used up all my MP on those scissor claws from Guagamon. Time to do some investigating. One thing I'm kind of iffy about when it comes to Digimon is, like, I'm kind of unsure about how I feel about the naming process. Like, it kind of reminds me of this one Sanity Not Included clip, where they were basically making fun of Pokemon designs like Vanillish, Vanillite, and all that, and they basically said, and they went with the joke of, for new Pokemon designs, why don't we just take any random object and add chew to the end of it? And so you had such hilarious monsters like Dorchu and Dilluchu for Pokemon. The funny thing about that is that that's actually more or less Digimon's naming concept. Well, how Digimon goes about to naming monsters. Like, except when you have Mon at the end of everything, and then you take anything, like any Japanese or English phrase of any kind, and then you just add Mon to the end of it. You got Tyrannomon, you got Geckomon, you got Doggymon, you got Gatomon, Angemon, Leomon, all that lovely stuff. Like, you can basically take any word and add Mon into the end of it and then give it a design and you'll have a Digimon of some kind. Like, you have Beetlemon already. There is technically a Pencilmon already, but it's not, I think its name uses the Japanese name for pencils. Opossummon, I think I remember seeing that. You get the idea. On one hand, that makes it so you don't have to be, like, come up with some kind of stupid pun or mishmash of words like you would with Pokemon. I hate the name Talonflame, man. That name just... I think that name is really just dumb. It's just two words put together. Talonflame. No? Like, there's not much of... I don't really feel like there's much creativity to that. Like, at least with the Mon thing, like, you basically don't have to waste your time on some stupid pun to come up with a name for that. But at the same time, it can kind of make the name for the monsters kind of annoying to some people, I would imagine. I guess that's more a matter of preference, though. I personally don't mind it. It just makes it easier to, like, remember certain Digimon names. Rather than some... like I said, I'm really not keen on all of the dumb puns or mishmash of words Pokemon names can end up being. That's just my thoughts on that. Looks like I gotta get to the other side over there. Yeah, if you're watching this, you can probably see a bit of frame drops in the game. Like, it doesn't bug me as much But since it's a turn-based RPG, but I never really had this issue when I played the PS4 version, not a friend's PS4. So I guess Digimon is a little too strong for the Switch. It's a slight performance issue that I've noticed, but it's nothing I would criticize too much, really. Please get out of my way, Otamamon. I feel like that's another good discussion point, like random crits like that. Like in any game, whether it's Team Fortress 2 or any turn-based RPG game or whatever, I really think random crits are not a good thing. They just diminish the need for like skill. Because like there are these random points where the game will decide, oh, you get to do double damage because like if you're to the point where like if you beat a boss just because you got a random crit and you were struggling any other time, like it didn't reward you for skill. You just got lucky because the game randomly decided you got lucky. Dark Cloud Delta saying, it only happens on this map and the final room of Kowloon level 5. Okay, so that makes sense. That's why that would explain why I don't really see it as much. The frame drops, I mean. That's interesting. Good to know. Still, frame drops in only two parts of the game. That's really nothing, really. Not much point, Chris, in whining over that. Like, it shouldn't be there, nonetheless, but at least it's not everywhere. At least it doesn't happen often enough that it becomes a problem, is a thing. So, like, if it happened constantly and slowed down this game so much, then it would be an issue, but it doesn't. So it becomes harder to notice or criticize it. Unlike a certain other monster collector where frame drops were pretty common. Dark Law Delta is saying, under Kowloon level 5, I know because that's where King Edamon spawns and he drops billionaire USB, and he is only in the final room. Oh, I did not know that. Okay. So I can get some really good, a really good money grinding item at that point of the game, huh? I had no idea. Yeah, that's actually another great thing that this game does. It gives you so many resources for EXP grinding and money grinding that both those things are pretty much a non-issue in this game. That's kind of like one of the things that are so great about Digimon, this particular Digimon game and Dragon Quest games in general. They make use of monsters like the Metal Slime Lime and the Goody Bag line, so you can get plenty of money and EXP. Without much issue. And in this game, it's stuff like Prince Mamemon and Platinum Numamon, so where you don't have that help it, so you don't really have to worry at all about EXP or money. Darklaw Delta saying, yeah, that's for hacker's memory, and it's recommended to hold large capacity USBs for it to drop it often. Okay, okay. I'll keep that in mind for if I... For, replayed to a hacker's memory and get to that part of the game. Someone's talking to me on the digital line. What do you want? Honestly, I kind of like the Tyrannomon line as far as design goes. Like, you got a Tyrannosaurus Rex, and then you got a cyborg Tyrannosaurus Rex that's all gray and evil looking. And then you'll have a huge robot Tyrannosaurus Rex X with Rust Tyrannomon after Metal Tyrannomon. It's gonna be great, man. Great, I tell ya. Great! Okay, what was I doing? Okay, so I was looking for keywords. Police hating hacker. Oh, go to Shinjuku, okay. NPCs, give me your knowledge. Where are you? Actually, I think that Arcadia mod metal I just got actually made me think of something. Like, I think with games like Yo-Kai Watch and Digimon, they basically aren't obligated to have the new Digimon and Yo-Kai they have in, like, a video game of any kind. They can just make them for whatever they want and show them off in any part they want, whatever they want. Like, Arcadia mod you have in this game, sure, but not all the Digimon are in this game. Or like that new Digimon that was introduced in the last evolution. And that, just that anime exclusive Digimon. And you also, and with Yo-Kai Watch you have a lot of Yo-Kai that are exclusive to mobile games, that's for sure. And they basically do whatever they want with those two. They aren't really obligated to have them be in a main series game. I feel like Pokemon just limits itself too much by with transferring, so it's expected every monster be available for transfer in some way, so that they can get more money out of people for being able to transfer monsters. Let's see. What am I doing now? Access point guy. ancient courtyard. Oh, this guy. Don't tell Twitter about this game. They'll praise this guy for saying cops are bad. I probably should have saved. Oh well. This is a certified Twitter moment. Dark Law Delta saying, fun fact, the Arcadium Online before Hacker's Memory came out was manga exclusive. Oh, okay. So that's kind of what I'm talking about. They can introduce a Digimon anytime they want, and then they can just make it in it for a game later at their leisure. I'm gonna have to switch out my Digimon team. I guess this is a good example of why you kind of need a team balance in this game of data, virus, and vaccine so you can deal with more situations like this. There we go. Second boss down. I think that's a good stopping place for now. Gonna heal up, save in front of there, and then I'll continue this from tomorrow. Or whenever I feel like it. No promises, sorry. I'm trying to stream every day if I feel like it. Dark Law Delta saying, thanks for the stream. Thank you for coming. I hope you have a wonderful night. Love y'all. Stay safe, stay healthy. We'll pick this up another time.